So next class of signals and systems. So we classified signals according to energy signal and power signal, causal signal and non-causal signal, periodic and aperiodic signal, continuous time signal and discrete time signal, etc. So we discussed all those signals one by one. So today we are going to discuss about causal and non-causal signal. Anything that carries information is known as signal. Anything that carries information is known as signal. Signal is a physical quantity which varies with time, space, or any other independent variables. Signals are broadly classified into one-dimensional signal and multi-dimensional signal. If a signal depends only on one variable, it is called a one-dimensional signal. The speech signal is a one-dimensional signal. What about a multi-dimensional signal? If a signal depends more than one variable, it is called a multi-dimensional signal. Image signal is a multi-dimensional signal. So all those things we discussed in the last, in the previous classes. Okay, anything that carries information is known as signal. Signal is a physical quantity which varies with the time, space, or any other independent variables. Signals are broadly classified into one-dimensional signal and two-dimensional signal. So we classify signals according to different criteria, maybe continuous and discrete time signal, periodic and aperiodic signal, even and odd signal, causal and non-causal signal, energy signal and power signal, etc. Okay. So today we are going to discuss about a causal and non-causal signal. What is meant by causal? Causal signal is a right-handed signal, whereas non-causal signal is a left-handed signal. What is meant by right-handed signal and left-handed signal? So a continuous time signal x of t. X of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. If there is no signal when t less than 0 and the value of t is negative, then if there is no signal, then that signal will be a causal signal. That signal exists only on right hand side. Therefore, that causal signal is also known as right-handed signal. So x of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. T less than 0 means when t is negative, there is no x of t. So signal doesn't exist in the negative values of t. The signal exists only on the positive values of t. Therefore, that signal is known as a right-handed signal. Such a signal is known as causal signal. Okay. What about left-handed signal? X of t is equal to x of t not equal to 0 when t less than 0. Such a signal is known as, that means if a signal exists on the left-hand side also, even if the value of t is negative, the signal exists in that part, definitely it will be a non-causal signal. So that is the difference between causal signal and a non-causal signal. Causal signal is a right-handed signal, whereas non-causal signal is a left-handed signal. In the right-handed signal or causal signal, there is no signal exists in the negative part. In the left-handed signal, signal exists only on signal exists even in the negative side of negative values of t also. Okay, so that is causal and non-causal. Further explanation about causal, non-causal and anti-causal signal. If it is a discrete time signal, how can we define a causal signal? In the case of continuous time signal, I told you x of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0, it will be a causal signal. In the case of discrete time signal also, we can say x of n is equal to 0 when n less than 0. When the value of n is negative, when the value of n is less than 0, there will be no signal. The signal exists only on RHS, right hand side. Therefore, causal signal is a right-sided signal, irrespective of the nature of continuous or discrete. So x of n not equal to 0 when n less than 0, that is a non-causal signal. On the right hand side of slide, you can see non-causal. X of n not equal to 0 when n less than 0. Even if the value of n is negative or less than 0, signal exists in that part also. Therefore, that signal is known as non-causal signal. Okay. What about a continuous time signal? X of t not equal to 0. We can explain all the category of signal in the category of continuous time and discrete time. Okay. Here, x of n not equal to 0 when n less than 0, in the, it will be a non-causal signal. What about continuous time system? X of t not equal to 0 when t less than 0, then it will be a non-causal signal. What about anti-causal? So, non-causal and anti-causal are different. Causal allathathellam non-causal aanu. So, anti-causal nu parnja different. X of n is equal to 0 when n greater than or equal to 0, right hand side la signal illengil
കോസലിൻ്റെ ജസ്റ്റ് ആൻറ്റി ആയിട്ട് പറയുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, കോസൽ അല്ല എന്ന് പറയുന്നതാണ്. ഇഫ് ദർ ഇസ് കോസൽ അല്ലാത്ത സിഗ്നൽ ആണ് നോൺ കോസൽ സിഗ്നൽ. വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ആൻറ്റി കോസൽ സിഗ്നൽ? എക്സ് ഓഫ് എൻ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു സീറോ വെൻ എൻ ഗ്രേറ്റർ ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു സീറോ. വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ടൈം സിസ്റ്റം? ഡെഫിനറ്റ്ലി യു ക്യാൻ സേ എക്സ് ഓഫ് ടി ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു സീറോ വെൻ എൻ ഗ്രേറ്റർ ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു സീറോ. ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി ആൻറ്റി കോസൽ സിഗ്നൽ. ഓക്കെ, വൺസ് അഗെയിൻ, കോസൽ സിഗ്നൽ ഈസ് എ റൈറ്റ് സൈഡഡ് സിഗ്നൽ, വെറസ് നോൺ കോസൽ സിഗ്നൽ ഈസ് എ ലെഫ്റ്റ് സൈഡഡ് സിഗ്നൽ. സോ എക്സ് ഓഫ് ടി ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു സീറോ വെൻ ടി ലെസ് ദാൻ സീറോ, ഓർ എക്സ് ഓഫ് എൻ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു സീറോ വെൻ എൻ ലെസ് ദാൻ സീറോ, ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി എ കോസൽ സിഗ്നൽ. X of t is equal to x of t not equal to zero, x of t not equal to zero when t less than zero, or x of n not equal to zero when n less than zero, it will be a non-causal signal. What about anti-causal signal? X of n is equal to zero when n greater than or equal to zero, or x of t is equal to zero when t greater than or equal to zero, it will be an anti-causal signal. I think it is clear, very simple. Causal, non-causal and anti-causal. Non-causal and anti-causal one is different. So there are some problems. Check whether the following signals are causal or non-causal. No need to say whether the given signal is anti-causal. ആൻറ്റിക്കോസൽ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ റൈറ്റ് ഹാൻഡ് സൈഡിൽ സിഗ്നൽ ഇല്ലെങ്കിൽ, എക്സ് ഓഫ് എൻ ഇസ് ഈക്വൾ ടു സീറോ വെൻ എൻ ഗ്രേറ്റർ ദാൻ ഓർ ഈക്വൽ ടു സീറോ ആണെങ്കിൽ ആൻറ്റിക്കോസൽ. ചെക്ക് വെതർ ദ ഫോളോയിങ് സിഗ്നൽസ് ആർ കോസൽ ഓർ നോൺ കോസൽ. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ, എ ഇ റേസ് ടു എ ടി യു ഓഫ് ടി. യു ഓഫ് ടി മീൻസ് യൂണിറ്റ് ടൈം സിഗ്നൽ. യു ഓഫ് ടി മീൻസ് യൂണിറ്റ് സ്റ്റെപ്പ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ. യു ഓഫ് ടി മീൻസ് യൂണിറ്റ് സ്റ്റെപ്പ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ. സോ We will discuss this unit step function u of t in the later classes. Anyway, I have to say some sentences about some points about u of t. U of t means a unit step function. That function exists only in the right hand side. That means u of t is equal to 1 when t greater than or equal to 0. U of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. So e raised to at means it is an exponential signal. Definitely it is an exponential signal. E raised to at u of t is equal to x of t. X of t is the given signal. The given signal is e raised to at u of t. U of t means unit step function. We will discuss the unit step function, unit ramp function in the later classes. Anyway, I have to say some points regarding this unit step function. Otherwise, we can't move this topic. Okay, u of t means unit step function exists only when t greater than or equal to 0. When value of t is less than 0, there is no u of t. So definitely the given signal is e raised to a t u of t exists only on the right hand side, because u of t is equal to 1. Please understand, u of t is equal to 1 when t greater than or equal to 0. U of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. T less than 0, there is u of t is equal to 0. Therefore, e raised to a t, u of t is equal to 0. So, e raised to a t, u of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. Therefore, definitely, the first question, e raised to a t, u of t is a causal signal. I think it is clear. Once again, u of t means unit step function. The value of u of t is always 1 when t greater than or equal to 0. The value of u of t is always 0 when t less than 0. E raised to a t u of t means e raised to a t into u of t. The value, if u of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0, means e raised to a t u of t is also 0 when t less than 0, because the value of u of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. That means e raised to a t into u of t is also 0 when t less than 0. That means signal doesn't exist in the left hand side. Signal exists only on the right side. Therefore, this is a right-sided signal or causal signal. I think it is clear. Okay. Second question, e raised to minus 2t u of minus t. The given question is x of t is equal to e raised to minus 2t u of minus t. E raised to minus 2t u of minus t. U of minus t is another unit step function. Any step function can be defined like this. U of minus t is equal to 1. U of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. Now bracket into ullilulla sambhavam greater than or equal to 0. U of t or u of 2t, u of minus 3t, u of 1 by 3t, whatever it may be. U of 1 by 3t is equal to 1 by 3t is equal to 1 by 3t greater than or equal to 0. That is the basic concept. Here u of minus t is equal to 1 minus t greater than or equal to 0. we have to change this minus sign. Minus t greater than or equal to 0 change aakkanundengil adine minus kondu multiply cheya. Appo minus into minus t plus t greater when greater than or equal to a minus kondu gunikkumbo minus into greater than or equal to becomes less than or equal to. Okay, so u of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. We have to change this minus t. So that means t less than or equal to 0. Minus t greater than or equal to 0 ennalladine minus kondu multiply cheyumbo minus t becomes plus t. Greater than or equal to becomes less than or equal to 0 ne minus kondu gunichu kanjalum 0 thanne. Okay, so what does it mean? U of minus t is equal to 1. U of minus t is equal to 1 minus t greater than or equal to 0. That means u of minus t is equal to 1 t less than or equal to 0. T less than or equal to 0. That means even if the value of t is less than 0 or negative, u of minus t will be there. Function x is on the left hand side also. That means u of the given function is not 0. The given function is not 0 when t less than 0. So this is not a causal signal. Not a causal means it is a non-causal signal. No need to say whether the given signal is anti-causal. The question is very clear. Check whether the given signal is causal or non-causal. Any doubt? I'm repeating. Itu korcha confused undaakuna oru bhagana karena class illathu kondu nammal online aayittu edukkumbulla chala budhimuttukalana appo pratheka manasilakkanam. U of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. That means u of minus t is equal to 1 minus 1 multiply cheya adayithu t less than or equal to 0 minus t greater than or equal to 0 ya minus 1 multiply cheyumbo t less than or equal to 0. That is u of minus t is equal to 1 when t less than or equal to 0. That means u of minus t exists when t less than 0. That means on the left hand side also the signal exists. Therefore the given signal is not a causal signal. Definitely it is a non-causal signal. Okay. Then third one. Sin ct, sinc function. Sinc t, sinct, sinc functioning is sin. This is not sin t. Sin ct means sinc function. Sinc function is shown on the right hand side of the slide. So t versus sin ct. So look at the graph. Sin sinc function like this is not, this is not a sinusoidal signal. This is a sinc function. Sinct means sinc function. Sinc function is shown as in the figure. From the figure itself we can understand that the given signal x is on right hand side and left hand side also. When t greater than 0 signal is there, when t less than 0 signal is there. So the given signal is not causal, because when the value of t is less than 0, the given signal will be 0, then that signal is called a causal signal. This signal exists on the left hand side also. This is not a right sided signal. So the given signal is a causal signal. The given signal is not a causal signal. The given signal is not a causal signal. Sinc function, if you are asking, if you are given a sinc function problem, first of all draw the figure. The figure is the answer of this problem. So figure explain us why this is not a causal signal. The reason is very clear. Sinc function is shown in the figure. On the left hand side also sinc function is there. Even if the value of t is less than 0, sinc function is there. Therefore the given signal is not a causal signal. What is the condition for causal signal? X of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. Here x of t is equal to sin ct is not equal to 0 when t less than 0. Therefore the given sinc function is not a causal signal. So first three problems are clear. And fourth one, u of n plus 3 minus u of n minus 2. Okay, first of all draw this u of n plus 3, another unit step function. U of n plus 3, how can I draw this u of n plus 3? U of n is equal to 1 when n greater than or equal to 0. U of n plus 3 means on the x axis center right 0, right side 1 2, left side 1 2 3 means minus 1 minus 2 minus 3. On the left hand side it will be minus 1 minus 2 minus 3. On the right hand side it will be 1 2. Okay, u of n plus 3, how can I draw u of n plus 3 means u of n plus 3 is equal to 1. Please understand the meaning. U of n plus 3 is equal to 1. And that is when n plus 3 greater than or equal to 0. N plus 3 greater than or equal to 0 means n greater than or equal to minus 3. Plus 3 upper thought book. N plus 3 greater than or equal to 0 means n greater than or equal to minus 3. That means u of n plus 3 is equal to 1 when n greater than or equal to minus 3. So from minus 3 onwards there will be a function, its value is 1. So we have to draw a horizontal line at 1 in y axis from minus 3 onwards, that is u of n plus 3. Clear? What is u of t? U of t is equal to 1 when t greater than or equal to 0. What is u of minus t? U of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. What is u of n plus 3? U of n plus 3 is equal to 1 when n plus 3 greater than or equal to 0. That means u of n plus 3 is equal to 1 when n greater than or equal to minus 3. Okay? If the value of n is greater than minus 3, the value of u of n plus 3 will be 1. So from minus 3 onwards, the value of u of n plus 3 is equal to 1. So draw a horizontal line at 1 in y axis from minus 3 onwards. U of n minus 2. Secondly, you have to draw u of n minus 2. What is u of n minus 2? U of n minus 2 is equal to 1. U of n minus 2 is equal to 1 when n minus 2 greater than or equal to 0. N minus 2 greater than or equal to 0 means n greater than or equal to plus 2. Minus 2 apparathiki poi. N minus 2 greater than or equal to 0 means n greater than or equal to 2. That means u of n minus 2 is equal to 1 when n greater than or equal to 2. When the value of n is 2 and when the value of n is greater than or equal to 2, there will be a function u of n minus 2 which is equal to 1. So draw u of n minus 2. U of n minus 2 is equal to 1. So draw a line in y axis at 1 from plus 2 onwards. So u of n plus 3 minus u of n plus 2 means u of n plus 3 starts from minus 3 onwards. U of n minus 2 starts from plus 2 onwards. So u of n plus 3 minus u of n minus 2 means that function exists between minus 3 and plus 2. Okay. The shaded portion is minus 3 to plus 2. This function exists only from minus 3 to plus 2. But minus 2 minus 3 that understood on a 0 on the left minus 1 minus 2 minus 3. The given function exists from minus 3 to plus 2. The given function exists on the left hand side and right hand side. So the given signal is not a causal signal. And the second part of the line is repeat. Okay, u of n minus 2 is equal to 1. Eppozhaanu u of n minus 2 is equal to 1 when n minus 2 greater than or equal to 0. That is n greater than or equal to plus 2. Value of n greater than or equal to 2. N in the value 2 um 2 nekkal koodudhalanengil u of n minus 2 avade undu adinte value 1 aanu. So draw a line at 1 in y axis from 2 onward. 2 means plus 2 onwards. U of n plus 3 is equal to 1 when n plus 3 greater than or equal to 0. That means n greater than or equal to minus 3. What is u of t? U of t is equal to all problems you have to unit step function. Without explaining unit step function. Unit step function is an elementary function. The value of unit step function, or unit step signal. U of n plus 3 is equal to 1 when n plus 3 greater than or equal to 0. You have to bypass that section. U of minus 5. U of minus 5t, u of minus 5t within bracket, u of minus 5t is equal to 1 when minus 5t greater than or equal to 0. Okay, u of 1 by 6n, u of 1 by 6n is equal to 1 when 1 by 6n greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so all these four problems are very clear. I think the signals are classified into causal signal and non-causal signal. Causal signal means x of n is equal to 0 when n less than 0. Non-causal means x of n not equal to 0 when n less than 0. Anti-causal means x of n is equal to 0 when n greater than or equal to 0. So very important point you have to understand means u of t. What is u of t? It is a unit step function. What is the meaning of u of t? U of t is equal to 1 when t greater than or equal to 0. What is u of minus t? U of minus t is equal to 1 when t greater than or equal to 0. In the minus 1 to multiply it, u of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. We have to remove that minus t. So minus 1 to multiply it, the minus 1 to multiply it, the answer is u of minus t is equal to 1. Because bracket rule of minus here, u of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. Apa t minus lada plus akan. Apa minus into minus t plus t. Greater than or equal to a minus 1 to multiply jimba less than or equal to. Apa t less than or equal to 0. So u of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. That means u of minus t is equal to 1 when t less than 0. Okay. Then what about u of n plus 3? U of n plus 3 is equal to 1 when n plus 3 greater than or equal to 0. That is n greater than or equal to plus 3 apparathikki vumba minus 3. Apo plus 3 apparathikki vumba minus 1 multiply cheyada karile karanam n inde sign positive aanu. What about u of n minus 2? U of n minus 2 is equal to 1 when n minus 2 greater than or equal to 0. N minus 2 greater than or equal to 0 minus 1 multiply cheyada karile n inde sign positive aanu. Then n greater than or equal to 2. Adhe samayam u of minus t is equal to 1 when minus t greater than or equal to 0. Ine multiply cheyumbo u of minus t is equal to 1 when t less than minus t greater than or equal to 0 ne minus 1 multiply cheyumbo t less than or equal to 0. Okay. Then next, deterministic and random signals. So what is meant by deterministic signal? If the characteristics of a behavior, if the characteristics or behavior of a signal can be predetermined, okay, it can be predictable, then that signal is known as deterministic signal. Behavior of this signal is predictable with respect to time. There is no uncertainty with respect to its value at any time. These signals can be expressed mathematically. For example, x of t is equal to sin 3t is a deterministic signal. X of t is equal to sin 3t is a deterministic signal. The value of x of t is equal to sin 3t is predictable at any value of t. Its nature can be predictable. Okay, the behavior of this signal can be determined earlier. So x of t is equal to sin 3t is a deterministic signal. What about random signal? Deterministic and stochastic signal. That means random signal is also known as stochastic signal. Just opposite the characteristics of a deterministic signal. The behavior of these random signals or stochastic signal cannot be determined, cannot be predictable. Behavior of the signal is random, that is not predictable with respect to time. There is uncertainty with respect to its value at any time. These signals cannot be expressed mathematically. Deterministic signal can be expressed mathematically. Random signals or stochastic signal cannot be represented mathematically. Behavior cannot be predicted. Okay, once again, deterministic signal, the behavior of deterministic signal can be predicted and it can be expressed mathematically. Behavior of random signals or stochastic signal cannot be predictable and cannot be represented mathematically. Clear? Behavior of deterministic signal can be predictable and it can be expressed mathematically. Behavior of random signal is not predictable and cannot be represented mathematically. That is the difference between random signal and deterministic. Random signal is also known as stochastic signal. Random signal is also known as stochastic signal. The next one, bounded and unbounded signal. What is meant by bounded and unbounded signal? Bounded means finite. For every system is bounded, but meaningful signal is always bounded. Every system is bounded, but all signal is not always bounded. So what is meant by bounded and unbounded signal? System is bounded, but meaningful signal is always bounded means there may be bounded signals and unbounded signal. Okay, signal and system are different. So we are now discussing about signals. The next topic is system. Leave the topic of system now. Anyway, for a finite input or bounded input, if the output is also bounded or finite, it will be a bounded. For a finite input, output is also finite, it will be a bounded. Finite means bounded, or bounded means finite. It will be a bounded signal. Okay, what about unbounded? Even if the input signal is finite or bound out, even if the input signal is finite or bounded, output is not finite or bounded, it will be an unbounded signal. Clear? Okay, that is bounded signal and unbounded signal. If input signal is a bounded signal, output is also bounded or finite, it will be a bounded signal. Even if the input signal is bounded or finite, output signal is not bounded or finite, it will be an unbounded signal. Okay. So I think all these topics are very clear. Okay, causal signal and non-causal signal. X of t is equal to 0 when t less than 0. X of t not equal to 0 when t less than 0. Causal signals are right-sided signals. Non-causal signals are left-sided signals. What about random signals? Deterministic. What about deterministic and random signals? Behavior of some signals can be predictable and can be expressed mathematically. Those type of signals are called deterministic signals. The behavior of some other signals are cannot be predictable and cannot be represented mathematically, called random signals or stochastic signal. Then what about the bounded and unbounded signal? For a finite or bounded input, output is also bounded or finite. It will be a bounded signal. Otherwise, it is an unbounded signal. Okay.